Hello, I'm Anjuli, and in this video I will show you how you can register your front-end application in Microsoft Entra Admin Center. Native and web applications both need a different kind of setup in the Admin Center, so I will show you how to do this for both types. So let's get started with registering a front-end application, and I will start by registering a .NET MAUI application. So if you go to the left to Applications and you click App Registrations, you'll see only one application is registered, and that is the Webshop API from my previous video about how you can register your API in Microsoft Entra ID. So now I will just add a new registration and I will call it Webshop MAUI, and you can leave this as it is, and I will come back to the redirect URI. This is necessary to configure for your .NET MAUI application, otherwise it won't work. You click register. The next thing we have to do is to configure the redirect URI. If you go to authentication, you can see platform configurations is still empty. So you have to click on add a platform. And because it's a .NET MAUI application, you have to click mobile and desktop applications. The third URI is the one you need, the MSAL and then your client ID and then //auth. This is needed to redirect after your client or your user has successfully logged in to your app. Click configure, and this also automatically saves the setting. The next thing we have to do is to add permissions that we have exposed from our API in my previous video. We have to add these permissions to this registration. If you go to API permissions and click on add permission, here on the top you can select my APIs, and here is my Webshop API registration. And as you can see, it already has my access as user permission listed here. If I click add permission, it will be shown here, but this isn't enough to actually make it work because you also need two other permissions. So we have to click add permissions again and then click on Microsoft Graph and then delegated permissions, and you need to click offline access. As it says, it's to maintain the data you have given it access to, and open ID to be able to sign users in. You can also choose the other ones, but they're not obligated to make this registration work. Click Add Permissions, and don't forget to grant admin consent for these permissions. Otherwise, these permissions will not be assigned to your registration. The next thing you have to do is to create a user flow. If you go to the left to External Identities and then User Flows, you can click New User Flow. A user flow is a configuration that allows the users to be able to create an account. Otherwise, your users cannot create an account, and when they go to the when they are redirected to the login page, they will only see a page where they can sign in with a username or an email address that already is registered in Entra ID. So don't forget this, otherwise your users won't be able to create an account. So I'll just call this sign up and sign in. And here I can choose an identity providers, and I don't have any identity providers configured, but here on the left at all identity providers, you can configure, for example, a Google or a Facebook identity provider, so that when you create a user flow, you can here choose Facebook or Google, and then your users can actually log in using their Facebook or Google account. But for now, I'll just leave it as is. Here at the bottom, you can choose user attributes. And these are the attributes that are collected when a user creates an account in your app. For now, I'll just only choose given name. But if you click here on show more, you can see the default user attributes that are configured in Entra ID. And you can actually add your own user attributes. Click create, and then your user flow is created. When your user flow is created, you have to click on the user flow, and you actually have to add your front-end application to this. So if you click on applications, You can here click again add application, and then you can see my Webshop Maui app is listed here. So if I click Webshop Maui and select it, then my frontend application is actually registered to the sign up and sign in flow. I haven't added my API to this sign up and sign in flow because I don't want my users to create an account directly on my API. I want them to reach my API through my Maui application. Now let's test if this actually works. I have created a simpleton and Maui application of which I will share the code in my GitHub repository. And this is just a simple application where there's one button where I can log in so we can see if it actually worked. So when I click login, it will send me to the URL of my customer tenant. And it will send me to this page. And if, like I said before, if you haven't created a user flow, this button to create an account won't be enabled. So if you register your application and you're trying to test it out and you come to this page but you don't have this button, then you probably forgot to create your user flow. So I'll just click no account, create one, and I'll enter my email address. Click next, and it will send me a code to my email address for extra security. And on the next page, I have to set my password, and I also have to enter a given name. And this is actually the user attribute that we configured when creating the user flow. So if you add other user attributes like postal code or address, it will appear on this page. Another cool thing is that there's already a password requirement configured in this page. So if I add a very bad password like 1234, I do it again, add my name and click next. It will actually give me an error that I have to comply to these minimal requirements of a password. If I click next, I will be redirected to my Maui app. And this shows that it works. Okay, now I'm going to show you how you can register your ASP.NET Core frontend application in the Microsoft Entra Admin Center. Since I've already shown you how to create a registration, this is exactly the same for creating a registration for any other frontend application, so I'll just skip that. And I've already registered my webshop web application. And but I still need to do the platform configuration, just like I did with the .NET MAUI application. So if you go again to authentication, I actually created this registration through Visual Studio, as I did with my web API in my previous video, and it already configured the platform configuration. But I will still show you what you have to choose. So if you click Add Platform and you click Web, then you have to enter a redirect URI, and it has to be the same as the one in your launch settings.json. So if you look at your launch settings and you go to Profiles and then underneath HTTPS, you have your application URL, and as you can see here, it has localhost 7163, and this one should also be entered here. But it's already configured here, so I don't have to do this, and after you click configure, it will be added the same way as it is already added in here. The next thing we have to do is to give this application permissions to the API. And here you can see it also already configured the offline access and open ID, which is always needed to be able to log in and create an account. So now we add permission for my API. And this is exactly the same as with a .NET MAUI application. Don't forget to consent. And the next thing we need to do is we already created a user flow, so we don't have to create a new user flow for this application. You can simply add this web application to the applications in the user flow. So here's already my MAUI application, and I'll just click add application. And I click my webshop web application. So now we can test this. And as you can see here, I will be redirected successfully to the Entra ID test tenant that I created. And here you can see that it also successfully added to the user flow because I can create an account. I'll just quickly go through these steps as we have already seen it with the .maui app. And after I've logged in, I can successfully enter my website. So now you know how you can register your front-end application in Microsoft Entra ID Admin Center. If you want me to make more videos about Entra ID, please let me know in the comments. And if you like this video, hit the like button or subscribe, and I hope to see you around soon. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.